long as he has existed, man has had to face danger. But today, it's not the big animals that are man's greatest enemies. Nor the smaller ones, for that matter. No, our worst enemies are infinitely smaller than that. Bacteria, viruses, poisons, toxins. Here are some that we need to fight.
If we could move into the stomach, we could cause good gastritis.
The nose makes the easy entry, and then you'll have a lovely cold.
Or a little allergy, believe me, that makes them feel sick.
What about influenza? What do you say to a nice Caribbean flu with high fever?
I still think infecting the stomach's a good idea. We can get in and develop with no problems at all. The body's defenses are useless.
Happily, we the body's sentries are here. The B lymphocytes, the T lymphocytes, the polynuclears, the macrophages, and many others. We're also known as white corpuscles. And in the human body, there are millions and millions of us. 200,000, more than the Earth's population, in one body. We protect it against foreign bodies and anything else that might harm it. Most of us are born in the bone marrow. Every day, 15,000 million white corpuscles come into the world. And all that would just about fill three big teaspoons.
Look, here comes old Fatty again.
Huh?
Watch this.
Oh! It's high time you were sent to school to learn how to behave yourselves.
Yes, they certainly are old enough to learn, I agree.
All right, kids, game's over. Get into groups of four, quickly, please. We're going to school. But what on earth is school?
What do we do there? Will we have fun there?
What is it called again?
The Thymus, the School for White Cells. You're already a few hours old by now. And it's time that you learned what you're supposed to do.
What is the thymus and where is it?
Yes, tell us. The thymus is here. It's the organ, of course, where our body's defense systems are formed. And your job is the best of all. You have to learn to spot the difference between enemies and friends. You'll learn to fight and destroy all those enemies. Your lives will really be full of adventure. And very exciting, too. Well, even if only for a short while, you'll see. And now, let's not waste any more time talking. Get going, kids!
And now, class, I want you to have a closer look at your future enemies. Be careful, because you must be able to recognize them at first glance. There are all kinds of viruses here. They need the human body's cells to multiply. And so they invade the cells and destroy them. They give us all kinds of illnesses, like flu, measles, mumps, polio, and so on. Watch these war films and you'll see how they go to work. There used to be the disease smallpox, but thanks to vaccination campaigns, we've been able to wipe out the enemy by keeping the troops ready for combat.
Pay attention. It's very important to know your enemies.
These are bacteria. They settle in snug little corners to multiply. They cause chickenpox, diphtheria, meningitis, and many other illnesses. Ah, here are the staphylococcus, or plain old coccus. They're extremely dangerous because they've learned to resist a lot of different kinds of medicine. They must be destroyed without mercy.
Hey, wake up! Otherwise, you'll never be able to recognize all your enemies.
But then there are also good, friendly bacteria that our body needs. There are millions of them that help us digest our food and make vitamins. Of course, we must never, never attack them. Lieutenant Clear, would you mind joining us for a moment?
At your command, Colonel.
This is Lieutenant Clare, a brilliant officer in our police force, who will introduce you to a few of your friends, your traveling companions.
There will be times when you will have to go right into the blood vessels. For us lymphocytes, or white blood cells, this is easy, because we are able to change shape. Our blood plasma, friends, proteins, lipids or fats, sugars, mineral salts, vitamins, and many others. And you know, they make up half the blood. They're almost all food for the body. And the body constantly needs a large variety of substances because it renews itself all the time. The other half of the blood consists of the oxygen carriers, the fuel of the cell motors. And these carriers, who give the blood its color, are our friends, the red blood cells. And these little platelets repair our wounds and regulate the fluidity of the blood. They are also our friends, but these kind and harmless platelets are completely unprotected. And it's one of our pleasant jobs to protect these little friends from the enemy. So you'll understand how important it is to know who to attack or not, and never to make a mistake. This is inclined to happen due to poor education, and when it happens, the body becomes anemic. So please pay careful attention.
What did she say?
Calling Captain Peter Jr. Calling Captain Peter Jr.
At your service, Colonel.
Won't you please join us, Captain Peter? I would like you to meet the ace of our nuclear police force, Captain Peter Jr. Captain Peter Jr. will tell you about your allies.
You may have already heard from the Colonel and Lieutenant Clare that our task is to fight and destroy all foreign bodies, the intruders, the invaders. We white blood cells come in different guises. The type B lymphocytes fight the enemy by dropping antibody parachutists. We drop 2,000 a second.
2,000 a second? Can you believe it?
And all these forces are for just one kind of enemy.
Excuse me, Captain, please. Why are they for only one kind, sir?
Because our defenses are programmed to react only to that one enemy. You see, these won't recognize another enemy.
I am Chief Antibody Metro. What can I do for you?
Explain to them.
All right, then. Well, we are specifically for the type C flu virus, but we have specialists in every area. And as you'll see very clearly, I have lots of clones. Well, dear friends, I'm afraid you'll have to excuse me. I have some visitors and duty calls. Not only duty, but pleasure as well, because to do one's duty is always a pleasure, you understand? Attack!
Sir, Captain, what does one do if there's a large enemy and only a single police vehicle?
Excellent question. In the first place, we're never alone for long. The others come as soon as we call. And then there's mitosis, the division of the cells.
But how do they do all of that?
We also have among us some highly deadly T units. They have a special type of action. Those of you who join Unit T must remember that you fight in close combat. And don't forget to let headquarters know about the situation so that they can send you more long-range artillery B units. All these represent only a small part of the white blood cells. The larger part are our faithful friends, the polynuclears, who fight the enemy directly and who don't hesitate about phagocyting or swallowing them. Our best friend, Lieutenant Jumbo Jr.
That's right. We are the combat infantry, and we're not exactly gentle. Death to the invaders, any way you like. Just get them.
It's not nice for those with a delicate tummy, but we just love it.
In the human body, we not only find invading enemy hordes, but also dust, dirt, waste products, and various toxins. Getting rid of these foreign bodies is the main task of our phagocyte units. And of our precious auxiliaries, the macrophage units. With them around, the place is clean. Dirt particles, viruses, and bacteria all disappear.
I guess you could say they certainly keep things clean, even if they don't wash whitest of all.
Yep, they swallow everything, those phagocytes, dead or alive, be it friend or foe. Those are basophiles. They fight allergies.
Get them!
Amongst our allies, I mustn't forget to mention little Interferon. He's an ultra-fast messenger who lets the neighbors know when a cell is being invaded. In that way, he gives them time to prepare the defenses.
Thank you very much for coming so quickly.
There's a virus invasion! All defenders to their posts at once!
Everybody to their posts. It's just a minor sector alert, class. Really nothing to worry about.
Let's continue. To fight efficiently, know who your friends are and who is the enemy. If you have any doubts, just remember that all the cells of the human body have an identical HLA mark. No other cell in the world has the same document. Show me your identity documents.
HLA? Now why haven't I got one of them?
Because you haven't got a nucleus. And everybody knows the red blood cells are our friends and wouldn't attack anybody, and it would never enter any well-educated body sentinel's mind to bother you.
And the badly educated ones, then?
Why worry, Fatso? You're big enough to look after yourself.
But we are all here to protect you, my good Hemo. Now off you go, and don't worry.
Okay.
To defend the red blood cells and other elements of the blood, you must penetrate into the blood vessels. Lieutenant Clare told you it was easy, remember? You see, the elasticity of our body enables us to squeeze through almost anything. So don't hesitate. Now, let's do a few tests. Tell me what you see over here.
A dangerous virus.
And here?
A cocky staphylococcus.
Enemy bacteria, destroy them.
And this? You there at the back, tell me what this is.
Well, I suppose it's dangerous bacteria.
Incorrect. If you'd listened instead of sleeping, you'd know. You've failed and will have to repeat this class. And you others, well done. You may leave and good luck.
All right, everyone, a bit of discipline. Get ready to penetrate the wall. Observe to your right a suspicious-looking cell. Now over to you.
Abnormal cell sighted. It looks malignant, Lieutenant. It's spreading rapidly. Risk of tumor to be destroyed immediately.
Well observed. Immediate destruction. Done, chaps. To keep an eye on transforming cells is one of our most important tasks. Thanks to our work, they don't invade normal cells. Right in front of us is the jugular vein. We're going into it. Follow me. We're heading towards the superior vena cava and the heart. Our objective is the right lung. We're about to arrive in the heart in the right auricle. Hold tight, it's going to be bumpy. Everyone still here? All right then, on we go to the lungs. Zone 37, this is where your first mission starts. We're going to separate now and each of you must patrol your own area. All right, off you go, but keep in contact.
blast some fresh air in these lung passages. This is patrol T-14. I'm on the inner surface of a bronchus in the right lung, and I am in contact with the outside world. All is calm here, Lieutenant.
Keep your eyes open. You're in a high-risk zone. That's where large pieces of matter are discarded, and watch out for invaders.
Hey! There's nobody here. Come on! Hurry up!
Right!
Come on out! Don't be scared. It's okay. There's no enemy in sight. Our objective, gang, is the mucous membrane. A lovely bout of double pneumonia. Here we are.
What on earth is that down there?
Too late, old chap. You're much too late, I'm afraid. There are already millions and millions of us.
That's what you think, Buster. That's what you think. This is Patrol T-14. Sound the alert. There is a viral infection in Sector 37. I've identified virus 346. Send reinforcements at once.
Okay, Number 14. White blood cells are coming up.
And I will try and fight them off in the meantime.
What's wrong, Paul? You don't look at all happy.
We can't win this battle. We're completely outnumbered.
Just be a little patient. You'll see.
Oh, you're the B lymphocytes. That changes things. Wow, that's efficiency for you. But there are still an awful lot of them.
Don't you remember what we learned? We can multiply by splitting.
Well, you just participated in a routine mission, Number 14. My compliments on your excellent judgment.
Oh, thank you.
The infection has been checked. Now you see, the body's defense consists of vigilance and information, and of course, of coordination. All right then, there are other jobs waiting.
Thank you for watching my video. If you enjoyed this video, please like, share, and subscribe for free.